I'm gonna start today on Lazarus and the Rich Man. As you noted that the rich man was real greedy, and Lazarus, the beggar, all he wanted was just the crumbs from the table. So I'm gonna do this piece here consisting of, well, that souls are descending into hell, and they shall be in fire. And Abraham will have the beggar in his bosom, holding him up on his side here. And that's more or less what that's gonna be about Lazarus and the Rich Man.
Now, what inspired you to work on Lazarus? Why this particular story?
Well, I was a lover of the Bible, whether I had read about how I didn't know a man could go to hell for just being selfish and greedy, not helping your fellow man. And I thought it would make a good piece to do, because a lot of people don't realize that it's a sin to be selfish and greedy to your fellow man. And you could go to hell just for that. Because the Bible says that all he did was just pardon the rich man, and he had everything he needed while he was living, and he lived in splendor. And the beggar, he lived and had a bad time, but how things can flip around. The rich man became the one who was worse than the beggar. He was tormented in hell, and the beggar, Lazarus, was in the bosom of Abraham, and it was a gulf set between them that you couldn't come and you couldn't enter in, no way. So it was a fixed situation where you were there, and to be separated from God the rest of your life, to be tormented in hell. That's the situation where the rich man realized. I got real interested in it because when I read the Bible, kind of touch me how you can easily get down here in hell by the simplest things. It's just one of those things where that I think the picture speaks, I tell picture worth a thousand words. So once we get finished with this, maybe we can tell a story.